Hi guys, welcome back. I am actually not going to be doing a video for you this week because I am incredibly busy with some holiday stuff, but I didn't want to leave you just completely in the lurch, so Jasper has very kindly volunteered to do something for you instead. And as you probably know, he has a strong interest in equipment and armor and that kind of thing, so that is basically what he's going to be doing for you today. And he is going to be working on this, which is a World War II German Flak 38 gun. This particular model is by Warlord. You can probably see that the gun barrel has been replaced on it, and that is because cast guns like this tend to get, I don't know, their barrels tend to get a little bit droopy sometimes or deformed. And if you're sort of a, I don't know, an armor fanatic like Jasper is, that's really annoying. So what he's done is he's cut off the original barrel of the gun, drilled it out, and replaced it with a bit of brass rod. And then he's taken just sort of the muzzle break at the end of the barrel that was part of the casting, sort of glued it back on the front. But you now have a sturdier, straighter looking barrel as a result. He is going to be airbrushing this model quite a bit, but he has nonetheless applied a black base coat to everything just so that there'll be coverage down in areas that the airbrush might have trouble reaching. You may also notice that he has that in a kind of a very horizontal format for a flak gun, but he plans to use it later in his World War II army, and there it's going to play more of a support role for his infantry, and it's going to definitely be, you know, it's going to be more just shooting at guys rather than at airplanes. So this week he's going to be showing you the gun itself, and then next week he's also going to be doing another video, and he's going to be painting up the crew to go along with it. So this is great for me. I'm getting not a one but a 2 week break from videos, though I'm not going to be totally absent, because I will be still doing the intros and the voiceovers for both videos, so in case you miss my wonderful voice and smiling face, you won't have to do totally without. So, okay, let's go ahead and let him get started. To start out, Jasper has airbrushed basically the entire gun using Vallejo Air Surface Primer Dark Yellow here, and he thins down his paint quite a bit, even though that paint is already pretty thin, just because it goes on a lot better that way. Jasper then added a little white paint to his mix and applied that to the sides and top of the model. For his final highlight, he added even more white and then just applied it to the top of the model, spraying downwards. And now it's time to add some camouflage to the model. When Jesper's going to be using Luftwaffe camouflage green for that, he has thinned it down with both Vallejo thinner and some matte varnish because he wants this to have sort of a faded, I don't know, airbrushed on effect, but it's too fine and delicate to really actually airbrush. It's just easier to do with a brush. So what he's going to do here is he's going to go back and make some fairly thick lines where he wants the camo stripes to be. Especially, you can see he's going to be putting it on to the sort of the guard shield at the front of the gun, because that area was often painted. And he's going to be putting it in some other areas too. And once he has applied these sort of very thin, light stripes, he's going to go back in with a finer, thinner brush and paint a second layer sort of down the middle of the stripes, which will give sort of that illusion of being sort of, you know, sprayed on, so it's darker in the center and then sort of more faded and light out towards the edges of the pattern. Next, Jasper quickly base coated the barrel of the gun and sort of the ammo cartridge box, which is sticking out of the side, just using some plain old black paint. Next, it was time to sort of weather and shade the gun a little bit, and this is just really best done with washes. So Jasper's taking here some Agrax Earthshade from Citadel, and he's thinned it down quite a bit with water because he doesn't want it to come off too heavy everywhere, since this is just more of sort of a general overall wash. But anyway, so he's got this sort of thinned down Agrax, and he's going to just apply that he's just really just going to glop it on pretty much everywhere on all parts
of the gun, and you know, obviously you want to make sure you get plenty down in all of the recesses and areas where you would expect there to be a really a lot of paint sticking, and don't let it puddle or pool too much on any of the flat, smooth surfaces, because obviously that'll look bad later on. Then Jesper very just lightly and quickly did a little highlighting on the top of the gun barrel and the cartridge box using some Vallejo German gray. Since the first sort of general wash is dry, Jesper's now going to go back in and start applying a pin wash. And this time he's using just pure uncut Agrax Earth Shade, so it'll be heavier and a little bit denser. And he's using a really fine brush here, you can see. And he's going to start working over just sort of areas where we want a lot of shadow and a lot of contrast, and sort of down in sort of all the recesses and nooks where you'd expect there to be just more shadow, but also more dirt and grease building up, and just all the, and really to help define those separate parts of the gun. But the trick here is to make sure you use very fine, small amounts so that, you know, you won't see it. It won't look too much like a wash here. It's just, it's a very good way to just add these, this extra definition. And you know, of course, when you're down in all of the components at the back of the gun, you'll probably have quite a bit of areas that you need to do, since this is a complicated piece with a lot of little sections and bits to it. But if you take your time here and do a good careful job, it'll really be rewarded, and it'll really make the gun look nicer, and all the parts will stand out neatly. And this is one of the kind of easiest ways you can kind of get this effect. When all of the wash is dry, it's time for a little bit of dry brushing here, and this is just with Vallejo Buff. You can see Jesper's got a great big flat stiff bristled brush, and so he's just applying a little buff, wiping most of it off, and then really kind of very lightly here, actually giving the whole thing a dry brush. And this is really mostly to catch all the edges, all the major sharp edges sort of at the front of the gun and on the top and stuff. And you know, you don't have to worry about necessarily getting down in every single little crevice here, but it's mostly just to accent the areas that you're gonna really see the most on the gun, and also just to help lighten it up and weather it a little bit further. Now Jesper's going to continue highlighting some of the metal areas. He's taken some Vallejo Air gunmetal here, and he's mixed in some black just to get it a darker metallic shade. He's going to use that to highlight the gun barrel here a little bit, get a little bit of that metallic shine, and also the cartridge box. And that's really going to be his first highlight, and it's going to be pretty subtle. And then he's going to take sort of a second highlight, which is almost pure gunmetal, so pretty metallic, and he's going to use that to add extra shine, especially on the top of the gun barrel and the muzzle. And then on the cartridge box, it has sort of like molded ridges on the top, but they're not sculpted in this particular model, so he's going to just paint those on by taking that brighter metallic color and just painting some sort of diagonal stripes, and those, and that'll at this scale it'll stimulate still very well the look of sort of molded 3D ridges. Now it's time to add a little bit of sort of chipping and dinging to the guns, and Jesper's using German camouflage black brown as sort of his first sort of chipping layer. And you want to put this basically on places where you'd expect the gun to be getting a lot of wear, like where the crew is stepping and standing on it a lot, or touching it, or it's getting banged or dinged against. In general, this is, again, as we've said before, chipping, less is really more, so don't do this too much. It'll look artificial. Real guns, they didn't ding up as much as people often think that they did. So once you put the German camouflage black brown initial layer, and then go back in with like some of the Vallejo Air gunmetal, and then you can just use that to accent even further a few of the chips to make them look even more severe. But you should, of course, make them even less frequent than just the pure brown ones, because that shows an even more extreme form of wear. Now, just below the muzzle, the gun has a couple little white bands, which, and Jesper painted these first using Vallejo light gray, and then he took just a little bit of pure white and used that to highlight just the very top of the gun barrel where, you know, more light was hitting. And you can then go back in with a little black if you want and sort of draw the line down the middle if you're not happy with how they lined up, or, you know, it just needs a little bit of cleaning up. Then Jasper very quickly painted the lens in the viewfinder. He did this with a little Vallejo dark Prussian blue. This is pretty obscured, so you don't have to worry about putting too much time or effort into this. So you just want to base coat the lens in that dark blue color, and then you want to probably put a little bit of highlight in. He used just a very light blue here. It's not particularly important which one you choose. It could be sky blue, whatever you have on hand. And then he just painted a sort of crescent half moon towards the top of it, and that looks like there's some light hitting, like you've got kind of just a little bit of reflection hitting the glass there, basically. All right, and here is our finished Flak 38. This is a nice little project. It's great, kind of not too intimidating if you're starting out doing armor or using airbrushes and you don't want to get too overwhelmed. You know, this really didn't take very long to do at all, and it's just a nice little model for your table. Of course, it still needs some crew, and that's something that Jasper's going to be working on for you next week, showing, you know, his style for painting figures, which is quite a bit different from mine, but also really nice, and it should definitely appeal to some of you who want a different technique. So if you enjoyed this video, please like it, share it, leave me your comments, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, because that's always very appreciated. And that's all for now, and we will see you next time.